Assalamu alaikum listeners and viewers, this is me, your host Fahad Younis, and you're watching Meri Kahani. And as you know, in Meri Kahani show, we've been introducing you with a lot of wonderful celebrities from around the world who actually made a difference in their life and now their motivation for a lot of other people. So today we also have a very lovely and honorable guest, Jack Sim, live with us from Singapore. And Jack is just amazing, I can say. And there are a lot of things to tell about the Jack, but you know, listeners and viewers, Jack is actually running World Toilet Organization. I mean, when you think about the toilet, we think that this is a crazy thing. But we will today discuss, with Jack that what is World Toilet Organization and how he survived in the past years. I mean, how his story starts. So Jack is live with us. Jack, thank you very much for joining us and most welcome in our studios. How are you doing?
Yeah, very good. I'm here in Singapore.
Thank you very much, Jack, for joining us. And it's a pleasure for us. You came to our show. So Jack, I mean, how you become like this? I mean, what happened to your life that you're here today?
Well, I was a businessman before, dealing with a range of businesses like real estate development, building material manufacturing. But at 40, I decided that life is only 80 years. And normally people die around 80. So for 40 more years, it's better to do something meaningful than to just try to make more money. Because actually for a short life, you don't need a lot of money. You can live a simple life and you do things with more meaning. And so I start looking for what is a good thing to do for society. And I realized that the toilet is quite neglected and people are very shy to talk because it's supposed to be embarrassing. Yet every day you must go to the toilet 6 to 8 times a day. And people without toilet or people without clean toilet, they have to go to public toilet and get really shocked. And sometimes cannot even find a toilet if you need one. Those are very inconvenient. So I started the World Toilet Organization to handle this issue.
All right. Awesome. So, I mean, Jack, as you told us that you made a difference about this thing and you started this toilet organization. I mean, would you love to tell us what is this organization doing? And I mean, what is the purpose of this thing?
Yeah, so there are two problems. One is for the cities and the developed countries, they actually have toilet, but very hard to find good public toilets. So we have to train the cleaners to be professional, to keep it dry and don't smell, and to maintain and repair toilets. Owners must be motivated to keep toilet as a service center and a profit center, because if you go to a restaurant or shopping center or school or office building, the building is not functional if there's no good toilet. So we managed to convince people that toilet is actually not an expenditure, but part of an essential service of a functional building. And the other problem, which is even bigger, is that is people with no toilet. So in this case, this become a very serious problem, because the 2.4 billion people still don't have toilet. And we can send spaceship to Mars and we cannot provide people toilet. It's really a joke, right? So long ago in 2001, when I first started the World Toilet Organization, on 19th of November, it was called water. That means they say sanitation subject is parked underwater. And when they talk about water, they forgot to talk about toilets and sanitation. So the people are dying out of non-hygienic lifestyle and the rivers are polluted with all the shit, and the people have no place to wash their hands, no water, no soap, and in many other countries, no toilet paper. So these are all very inconvenient. And so we started to create the World Toilet Organization and make it very funny because we call ourselves the WTO, sounds like the World Trade Organization. We intentionally play a pun on them so that if the World Trade Organization will sue us, then the subject of toilet will become a very, very big media news. And they didn't sue us, and we continue to be able to use the acronym. And the news love us, and we make a lot of humor mixed with serious facts. And now it's 16 years, and in India, they are building 110 million toilets. The Prime Minister decided that toilet is a vote winner, and all over the world, politicians are using toilet as a vote winner. I'm sure in Pakistan, this is also something politicians should use. So I hope that we can also create the same toilet revolution in Pakistan so that everybody can enjoy wonderful, nice toilet in your country.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. I really appreciate, I mean, the work you're doing right now. And Jack, I mean, if people want to be part of this, I mean, struggle, or if they want to, you know, be volunteer for your organization, I mean, how they can reach you out, and what is the procedure to be part of, you know, this revolution?
So anybody who like to start a Pakistan toilet organization can please contact me at worldtoilet.org or my Facebook, and I'll be so happy to help you, because I think everywhere, no matter who you are, toilets are so important. And in especially in the Hadith, the scholar book of Islam, there is a very precise instruction that cleanliness is important before prayer. So let's use that and keep ourselves clean and healthy and happy.
Of course. Thank you very much for such a lovely, motivational message. And Jack, I mean, you've been running this organization. Do you doing anything else? I mean, some other ventures do you have? Can you please share shortly with us?
Every year, 19th of November is United Nations World Toilet Day, because the United Nations has adopted the founding day of the World Toilet Organization, 19th of November, as a UN day. So every of the 193 countries are celebrating it. And of course, this is only a special day, but every day is a special day for the toilet. So what I felt is that school toilets are very important, and children need to start to learn from school about how to keep clean. And then the investment in toilet, and the people have to build their own toilet, clean it, make it beautiful. And I think poverty alleviation has a very important part to play by the toilet. If the toilet is clean, you save a lot of money, not having to see the doctor, not having to stop work to bring your children to see doctor. So when the parents have to stop work that day, you will lose the income. So keeping healthy, having toilet, washing hands with soap, very, very important.
Thank you very much, Jack Sim, for being part of our show. And anything else if you missed or if you want to share with the audience?
I would like that wish everyone a healthy life and enjoy yourself and be thankful that you have a toilet.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Jack, for joining us, and we'll be connected in future too.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. Take care. Bye. So you hear the story of Jack Sim, you know, he's running the World Toilet Organization. You can also be part of that organization by visiting World Toilet Organization's official website, and you can also share your suggestions and your comments with us on facebook.com/Meri Kahani and as well as facebook.com/Fahad Younis, and you can also visit our website, which is merikahani.org. See you next week. Take care. Have a good day. Bye-bye.